Hello, investors and traders, and welcome to the weekly market report with the Market Guys. I'm AJ Monte. This is a one-year daily candle chart of the Russell 2000 Index, ticker symbol RUT. And if you've been following along with our weekly market reports, you'll know that I leave my lines in place from the previous week's report so that you can see how accurate technical analysis is as a forecasting tool. And as I zoom in here, you'll see that this diagonal line is what I drew last Friday. At the end of last week, I drew that line, and I said that the Russell 2000 would most likely drop to test the 20-period moving average, which is that blue line, and then bounce. And as you can see, the evidence is right there. The Russell 2000 did come down yesterday on Thursday the 19th. The market traded down and then closed higher, but the low of the day hit my target precisely right there at the end of that diagonal line is my target price, and then we bounced. Now, what does that mean for next week? Well, a lot of the positive news that came out today with regard to tax reform really affected the markets because investors are becoming very optimistic that extra money in the pockets of Americans is going to stimulate the economy. But we have to be very careful because the technical signals of not just the Russell 2000, but the markets across the board are showing extremely overbought conditions. And if I zoom out again and even go to a weekly chart, you'll see exactly what I'm talking about here. With the Russell 2000 being in this bull market, from here back at the low right around 2016 all the way up to the highs now. And you could see that in the course of the price action, you could see that there's these periodic pullbacks. So we are overdue for one of those pullbacks. And that's one of the reasons why I tell investors and especially our clients to be very defensive as they take any new positions in the market. During the course of the week, I do send out trade candidates that assume long positions in the market, but we're very cautious and even defensive when we take these longs. So we're looking for bounces, just short-term bounces. We get in, we get out very quickly, take our profits, and we move on. So for next week, I do believe that the Russell 2000 is going to go up just a little bit more to test the high from back here. I think there's a resistance point right back with data is that that's October 4th. There's a resistance point right there that I think will be tested, and then I think we could pull back from that point as the market turns back and away from that resistance. So that's my forecast for the Russell 2000. We look at the spiders, that's ticker symbol SPY. Very similar thing happened where my forecast was that we would pull back later in the week. We didn't pull back all the way to the 20-period moving average, but we pulled back enough to justify that as a bounce. And now we see higher highs. Now, the spiders is tracking 500 stocks, where obviously the Russell 2000 is tracking 2,000. So I think, again, we could see a little bit higher in the S&P next week, but eventually I think we'll pull back to that 20-period moving average once again. So I'll get rid of this line to clean it up just a little bit. And I'll leave these lines in place so you can see the history and how well these forecast lines work out. One other thing you have to watch out for in the spiders is we'll most likely start to see a drop in volume. I'll take note of that again next week. The drop in volume will signal a lack of enthusiasm on the side of the buyers. So that's the first thing that you'll see before the market pulls back. You could actually see prices go higher on lower volume, but the lower volume signals that a top is forming and a possible pivot point is about to show up. So that's why I think we're going to go just a little bit higher because of the momentum close today. And then eventually as that fizzles out, we can see a pullback. Remember, there's an old saying, you buy the rumor, sell the news. And with the tax reform news coming out and looking like it's going President Trump's way, and that would be a good thing for investors and especially middle-income families, having an extra $4,000 in the bank can go a long way with meeting bills and maybe even buying a car or putting a down payment on a car or something like that. So I think it will stimulate the economy. Now, if we look at the Qs, ticker symbol QQQ, this is the NASDAQ market basically representing the power shares. Again, same thing, said the market would pull back to bounce off of this line. This horizontal line here was what I drew last week as the roll reversal support. So we came back just like I said we would, didn't hit the 20 period moving average, but we came back enough to get that bounce off of that roll reversal support. Now, like I said before, with the volume, look at the volume down here. I'll zoom in just a little bit more. Today's volume was higher, but it was on a red candle. If we see a lower volume at the beginning of next week, and it, again, could even be on higher prices, we could see a rally to test that high resistance there. And then like the other markets, I think we could pull back, especially to fill this gap right here. The NASDAQ market gapped up today, and those gaps generally fill about 80% of the time. So that's going to act as a price magnet. So we'll leave that in place. Remember, we're expecting a pullback in volume, slight rally into the early part of next week with a pullback later in the week to fill the gap and come back as buyers take some of those profits off the table. So that's the NASDAQ market. Now, interestingly enough, for weeks I've been talking about how the VIX would fill the gap, and I've staked my reputation on that. You can see yesterday, that's Thursday the 19th, the VIX did rally enough to pull back from this resistance right here. You see the VIX rallied up, came very, very close within pennies to filling that gap, and then today, obviously, the VIX was lower. Now, what does this mean for next week? This is not as tricky as it looks. Remember what I said early on, I believe that the S&P is going to go higher before pulling back. The VIX, this is a hammer pattern. I'm not quite sure the VIX is going to pull back next week. In fact, I think on the contrary, I think the VIX is going to start to rally once again to go back up to this resistance point. This hammer pattern right there, it's a small bodied candle with a long shadow underneath. That's extremely bullish. And if you've been following along with the market, guys, I talk about the hammer patterns and the shadows and the length of those shadows quite often. So pay very close attention to that, because if you look back in history, anytime we see long shadows like that here and even here, the VIX is followed with rallies across the board. Again, here's a long shadow underneath the candle. But go back even further, you'll see here is a very long shadow, very similar to what we saw today in length, and an extreme rally in the VIX to follow that. So I think you, again, should take note of the shadow. The VIX has a very high probability of rallying next week, which would be bearish because it's a contrarian indicator to the S&P. So keep that in mind as you approach the markets in a defensive way. Now, next Monday, we're having our open house Q&A session, which is a monthly event that we put on. It's live. We answer your questions. We analyze stocks. We have a good old time of just talking about the markets. And that will begin on Monday the 23rd. If you go to our website, scroll down just a little bit, you'll see a link right there. If you click on that link, it'll bring you to our registration page, where all you have to do is fill that out, click register. It's free. And then you have now reserved your seat by doing that. So feel free to join us again on Monday the 23rd at 8 p.m. Give the link out to your friends, post it on the social media. We want to have a good crowd. Even if you're just listening in like a fly on the wall, you're going to pick up some good ideas about the markets and maybe even pick up a trade candidate or two as we look at the stocks and analyze the stock symbols. So that's it for now. Have a great weekend, and we'll talk to you soon. So long.
This video segment is a small part of what the Market Guys offer through their educational products and services. If you are interested in any of our Trade Alert services, or you would like more information about our one-on-one mentoring program, simply contact us at info@themarketguys.com.